Hey guys, it's Holly. Welcome back to my channel. Yes, I'm in my bathrobe, but that's just the way it is right now. So, anyways, so tonight's video is going to be about Martha in the Bible, and it's going to be about Martha's stress and anxiety, essentially. So, I'm just going to dive right in, and I will be reading just a little bit from my phone. But basically, a lot of scholars and a lot of people that study the Bible will try to say that Martha had this mental illness. So, for those of you that don't know who Martha is in the Bible, she is essentially the sister of Lazarus, and as we know, Lazarus died and he was resurrected. And so Martha was kind of like just a worried individual. She was a high-strung, just kind of, you know, got worried easily, stressed out easily over certain things, and that was just the way that she was. And to me, from the accounts that we read about Martha, that's what I get from that. I don't get that she had a mental illness. I don't get that there was something wrong with her. I just get that she was by nature a person that was prone to stress, a person that was prone to being anxious about things, quite frankly. And so, you know, I think it's really important to consider that, because like I always say, society tries to put so much emphasis on this whole mental illness thing, you know, and I'm not saying that, you know, mental illness entirely does not exist. I just think that we use it way too widely, and I don't think, in my personal opinion, that mental illness should be a definition that describes people like this, people that have these. You know, everybody's different. So some people are going to be more prone to being stressed and anxious and worried and nervous. And some people are going to be prone to being sad and, you know, just like despair and whatnot. And everybody's different. And I really feel like the Bible models these different types of people. And if you really look at it, you'll see that there are a lot of different examples in the Bible of, you know, depression and anxiety, yes, but not, in my opinion, should never be considered mental illness. And so it's like a whole nother thing. I'm not going to get into it, but you guys, if you watch my videos, you know how I feel about this. But anyways, I'm going to read you just a little bit on my phone. This video will be pretty short because I have a pretty strong opinion on Martha, and I don't have a lot to say about it. I just have a really strong opinion that there's nothing wrong with her, and we only have this little bit of scripture to go off of. It's just literally one fragment of her life, and it's like, you know, if we just look at that one fragment of her life, it's almost like we're only seeing that one little bit. We're not even seeing her whole life. You know, we can't say that she's mentally ill. And it's like, I was reading through all these other articles where people are like, oh, mental illness and Martha. It's like, Martha was not mentally ill, you know. So anyways, so let's get into the scripture. So this one particular article that I was reading that I came upon first, I really liked, because it said, this one blogger that had wrote this particular article. So basically we're talking about Mary and Martha and their story, the story that the Bible gives us about them. But so this particular girl that wrote this article, she says, "Let me begin by making it clear that I am not referring to any clinically diagnosed anxiety disorder, but rather to the natural human tendency to stress and overwhelm that we all feel." And I was like, yes, somebody gets it. Somebody is saying what needs to be said, because it's so true. And so in the gospel, Martha and Mary are two sisters who respond to Jesus' presence at their home in two different ways. Mary sits at his feet, listening attentively, resting in his presence, and Martha, well, she's another story. Martha, burdened with much serving, came to Jesus and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me by myself? Do you not care that my sister has left me by myself to do the serving? Tell her to help me." So, and then Jesus responds and he says, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many things." Okay. And then he says, let's see. Hold on one second, guys. So then it just goes on to say, you know, when we experience anxieties, it's as if we're in pieces. And Jesus recognized this in Martha and spoke peace into her busy life. So he continues his message to her and he says, "There is need of only one thing. Mary has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her." Jesus explains that Mary chose the better part while Martha tried to manage and coordinate every divided part of herself. So what does this mean for us? When we're anxious and worried, we are in parts. Psychological health does not require us to eliminate our natural anxious reactions, but rather to simply choose the better part. So obviously, I think we can all pretty much relate to this, especially as women, especially if you're a mom, or just period. I mean, even if you're a guy, like, there's the world that we live in nowadays is just so full of so many things that we have to do. Even if you don't have kids, even if you don't have someone to care for, it's still really hard and you're still going to find yourself really busy. So anyway, so that was my favorite article that I read about Martha. So Martha is a biblical figure described in the Gospels of Luke and John. Together with her siblings Lazarus and Mary of Bethany, she is described as living in the village of Bethany near Jerusalem. She was witness to Jesus resurrecting her brother Lazarus again. So, and now a scripture about anxiety. This is a very well-known scripture, but it just says, "Casting all your anxieties on him because he cares for you. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God." Made known. "When the righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and delivers them out of their troubles." Okay. So there are a whole bunch more different verses about anxiety. And they're in the Bible for a reason. And so anxiety is a normal part of life, the same as depression. And that's what, you know, I really try to emphasize with people, because I think we've been so trained to believe that it's a mental illness. But in reality, you know, whether you're a Christian or not, like I always say, the Bible shows us that these are normal parts of life. But society, on the other hand, tries to tell us, no, this is not normal. You should not feel this way. If you feel this way, you must have something wrong with you. You must be mentally ill. You need to go to therapy and you need to take medication. And you need to do this and you need to do that. And it's not okay. And what we really need to emphasize to society is that it is okay. It is normal. And I think the more we can normalize it, the more people can feel better about it and start to overcome and deal better with their emotions and just deal better in general and be able to live a happier, healthier life mentally. Because I really think the societal influence on saying, hey, this is not okay for you to feel this way, is a huge problem. Because in reality, who doesn't feel that way so many times, you know? Anyways, so let me see if there's anything else I want to add to this. So basically, you know, Jesus just tells Martha, like, hey, you know, you are too worried right now. Basically, in layman's terms, you need to just calm down and chill for a few, and you can get back to work shortly, okay? And sometimes that's just what we need to do. And so ultimately, that's about really there all is, really there, all there is to it, guys. So I do have a pretty strong opinion on this one, just because of all the different studies where people will try to say, you know, that Martha is mentally ill. And I can't take it. I can't stand that. And I just think it's so completely false. I just think it's absolutely absurd, quite frankly. So that is just my opinion. Like I always say, I'm not a psychologist. I'm not a psychiatrist. I am not a doctor. I am just someone that likes to share my personal opinions and my own personal knowledge on certain matters. So I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.